induction ceremony for 2019, I would like to open us in prayer, so if you would join me in prayer. Dear Father, we lift you up this day today, this ceremony today, this special occasion today where we induct people of character, people of service, leadership, and many qualities that you yourself had envisioned in us. By becoming the servants that we were always meant to be, like you have done so for Mary, like you had done so for us, becoming the servant, becoming the lamb, and becoming the pinnacle of character, leadership, and all of the above. We lift this day up to you today in order to not only honor the inductees today, but to also honor you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you all for coming and joining us for this very important event, the National Honor Society Induction Ceremony. I am Mrs. Lloyd, and I am the current advisor to OCSI's Agape Covenant Chapter of the National Honor Society. Now it is my honor to introduce to you the current members of OCSI's NHS. First up, our president and chaplain, Kaito Kanazawa. Next, our vice president and secretary, Leona Castro. Our treasurer, Milia Mizuguchi.
So to begin with the ceremony tonight, we'll start off with the candle lighting ceremony. Here you'll see seven candles line up, starting from the center, the short white one, with leadership, with knowledge. The candle of knowledge will be lighted first, as knowledge is the beginning, because the light of knowledge allows us to see and understand the other principles to which we obtain all of the other characteristics of the candles. I will now begin by lighting the center candle, the candle of knowledge.
Leadership should give a wholesome influence in our school. In taking the initiative in class and school activities, the real leader strives to train and help others to reach the same goal. The prize of leadership is sacrifice, the willingness to give charge to each of our members. Citizenship. Being a citizen means taking care of the society you live in. This is done if you follow the model that Romans 12:2 gives us. Do not conform yourselves to the standard of this world, but be transformed by a renewing of your mind. To be a citizen, we must take stand and stand firm. We must look out for the welfare of our fellow citizens by using our abilities and knowledge. Service can be described in various ways. In the routine of a day's work, many opportunities come up where we can help others. Willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without getting paid or without getting recognition is the quality we seek in our membership. We are committed to the idea of volunteering our time and abilities to the creation of a better tomorrow. Character is the force within each person which distinguishes that person from all others. It gives each one individuality. It is that without which no one can respect oneself nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character which accompanies a person through life and once developed grows steadily. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant action, daily striving to make the right choice. By demonstrating such quality as reliability, honesty, and sincerity, members of the National Honor Society may hope to prove by example that we value character.
Spiritual growth is a demonstration of an open heart and an open mind to seek God and know Him, developing a personal faith. Someone once asked Helen Keller, "Do you think there is any affliction worse than the loss of sight?" Ms. Keller thought for a moment and replied, "Yes, is to have eyesight and not see. Spiritual growth implies that a person is on a quest to develop his or her faith, and it stands as an important quality for members of the National Honor Society. As I read your name, please come forward and light your candle from the candle of knowledge. Then step over to the microphone and say a few words to acknowledge your induction. Then extinguish your candle, place it in the basket, and receive your membership card and a certificate from Ms. Childers and a rose from Mrs. Lloyd. Then return to your seat on the stage. Himari Amagata. I'd like to thank my family, friends, teachers, and coaches for helping me along throughout my life. I wouldn't be standing here without all of you, so thank you. Kayako Kusumado.
really excited to be a part of NHS for all of the development of growth, character, and knowledge, and all of the things that NHS, I don't know what to say, but just thank you so much for this.
Phoebe Fox, who is not here today, but will be inducted on a separate date, but is an inductee nonetheless. So. Gia Gallen.
I am honored to be part of National Honor Society, and thank you for everyone, especially my parents, my friends, who have come to support me.
Thank you, and I feel so honored and blessed to be part of the NHS.
Ray Kinchel.
And principal for supporting me throughout the whole high school, and I'm going to try my hardest to be a good NHS member. Thank you.
Elise Kiyoki. Thank you.
Sean. Thank you for everything, my family, my coaches, my teachers, for the best. And yeah, thank you.
First, thank my family and friends who helped me get to this point, and I'm very honored and excited to start my new journey as an NHS member. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, I passed the test. Cool beans. Good evening. Whoa. Good evening.
Good evening.
That means you can reply back. All right. Let me get my notes open here so I can stay on track. Don't start the clock yet. We'll get there in a minute. All right, good afternoon, officially this time. To our distinguished guests, our principal, Mrs. Lloyd, our advisor to NHS, to our parents of these wonderful young people sitting up here in front of us, friends and other family members. As I was sitting there tonight or this afternoon looking up on stage, I think that my life personally has been touched by everybody up here. In some way we have a special relationship. Murphy, Murphy, Murphy. I want to thank my granddaughter, Amelia, for asking me to be your speaker for this event. And yes, she is a granddaughter. I know that that probably went through the committee, but thank you all for giving me this opportunity to not only speak life into our inductees, but into all of our lives. Since I promise not to be long as I can be sometime, I'm a Baptist preacher by trade, and we tend to get long-winded. I promise not to do that tonight because I know that my time is limited as I stand here. So I brought a checklist with me tonight to make sure that I do this by the book. And I was also reminded by my boss to keep it under the limit. So the first thing on my checklist says to show up. I did that. Get up when called. I did that. Now it's time to speak up in approximately 8 minutes. I'll be sitting down. And since time is of the essence, I'll go straight to my target. Young people, in a few minutes ago in your pledge, this is what I heard you say. I pledge myself to uphold the high purpose of the National Honor Society to which I have been selected. I will be true to the principles of which it stands. I will be loyal to my school. I will maintain and encourage high standards of scholarship, service, leadership, citizenship, character, and spiritual growth. I want to target those last two standards of character and spiritual growth. First of all, a working definition for character. It is the mental or moral qualities that are distinctive to an individual. And we can say that are unique to an individual. Some synonyms that we would use with that word are personality. You talk about the person's personality. You talk about their nature. You talk about their temper, their disposition, their temper or temperament, or even their mentality. I like to define it this way. It is how you act when no one is watching. Everybody has learned the art of doing the right things because the right people are watching. But true character comes out in what you do when no one is watching you. I like to believe that all of you have a very good foundation because of being here at OCSI. And that one day you'll need to fall back on that. Let me offer a piece of advice that I learned from a guy. I call him a very dear friend. He is deceased now. I never met the man, but I have studied his sermons. I've read a lot of his books. His name is Dr. Miles Monroe, and one of the things that he said was, learn from others, but never try to become them. Remember that, and I'll come back to it in just a little bit. We're talking about character. Know that God made you special and important. And this milestone tonight is a testament to what God is doing in your life. Now listen, let me give y'all a little hint. Audience, close your ears for a minute. Listen, would you step off the mic, okay? I'm talking to you too, Sean. opportunity. I thank God for this opportunity. I thank mom and dad, being good friends and all that kind of stuff. Okay. Make sure you acknowledge the people that are important in your life. Okay? Just a little bit.
All right. Carry on, Sean.
This milestone tonight, again, is a testament to what God is doing in your life. Learn all that you can. Read about other people that have come before you, and believe me, there are many. You're not the first one to go down the trail. Okay? Read about them, their trials, their struggles, their hopes, and their dreams. Sit down and talk with your parents. Talk with grandma and grandpa if they're still alive. Learn all that you can, and then go out and do life as God shows you how to do it. The best book that I can recommend for any of you, in this book you have, and it's a book that you've already been exposed to, it's the Holy Bible. It's full of bios, it's full of wisdom, it's full of history, and whatever else you need. Study it. Listen, it is the only book that you will ever read. Watch this. It is the only book that you will ever read, and the author is always present with you. There's no other book in the world that can make that claim. Remember, too, that God created you as an original. You are special and important. There is no one else in the world exactly like you. You're it. So let that character come out. The fact that there's nobody else in the world like you, exactly like you, also implies that you have unique gifts and talents that must be shared. Listen to what I'm saying. That must be shared with the world. Okay? These are just the beginning steps. This is just the beginning of it. Why must I share it with the world, Mr. Reddy? Because God created you special and important to do good work which he prepared for you to do in advance. Go back and read Ephesians 2, verses 8 through 10. Now a little bit about spiritual growth, because I know the clock is ticking. Stay always open to growing in the Lord. Let me say it this way. Have faith in God and in yourself, and know, watch this, young people, know that you are enough. One of the best pieces of advice that I can give you is don't give up on who you are to become something for somebody else. Okay? You've got to get up every morning and look at that man or that woman in the mirror. Okay? Be pleased with yourself. Spiritual growth. This is why I said earlier, learn from others, but don't try to become them. The person in you that God created is enough to accomplish all that he has put in your hands to do. And just in talking with some of you, I know that you're already realizing what those gift sets are. Okay? If not, talk with somebody. How do we grow spiritually? By studying the Word of God. Daily. I'm sorry, I know this may sound like a sermon, but I'm not preaching. That's what we get. How do we grow? By studying the Bible. Do that on a daily basis. The Bible says to study to show yourself approved unto God. Not unto your friends, not to go back and beat them across the head and talk about how much you know, but to help you grow and develop into the person that you are becoming. Because believe it or not, you will become. You will become, and you don't want to stumble upon that. You are not intended to be a spiritual babe all of your life. You are expected to grow up in him. Let me finish up by offering some advice commensurate with all of this gray hair. No comment from you, Sean. With all of this gray hair that I carry with me every day. This is from an article written by a lady by the name of Regina Brett. She's an author and she's written a few books. But this particular article is entitled 45 Life Lessons. And it has some very practical advice. I'm not going to give you all 45. I do have a copy of it if you want it. I'm not going to give you all 45, but I read through the list, and I pulled out 10 of them that spoke to me. So listen to these, and I'll be done. Life isn't fair, but it is still good. Listen to this one. Life isn't tied with a bow, but it is still a gift. Number three, and these are in no special order. Number three, life is too short for long pity parties. Get busy living or get busy down. Number four, when in doubt, just take the next small step. I could expound on that, but we'll talk about it later. Number five, as you grow up and you come into these kinds of things, number five, pay off your credit card every month. Yeah, I can hear some of the parents out there. Pay off your credit card every month. I would surely like to expound on that one, but again, time is not on my side. Number six, as it relates to money, save for retirement, starting with your first paycheck. Okay? Number seven, don't compare your life to others. You have no idea what their journey is about. And I particularly like these last three that I'm about to give you. Everything can change in the blink of an eye. But don't worry, God never blinks. Number nine, God loves you, listen to me. God loves you because of who God is, not because of anything that you did or didn't do. You're going to be loved by Him anyway. And number 10, and this is a biggie, even for me as I grow into my senior years. This is a biggie, and I know it is a biggie with the young people because I talk to you all. Listen, what other people think of you is none of your business. Your business is to go out and be the best version of you that you can be. All right? Thank you. Now go forth and do great things. It's what we have come to expect from you. Thank you.
Each and every one of us as we go forth from here tonight, that you would just continue to bless our time.